Hello friends, welcome to AKS. Today we'll be dealing with 11th of September Hindu editorial discussion. Let us start the discussion. The first article here, factoring in safety. This article deals with the industrial accidents being happening in the recent past. What is our occupational readiness to curtail the situation? We'll deal this article in detail. The next article here, hard fought glory. This is about Rafael Nadal winning 19th Grand Slam. We'll deal this article, though the article is itself not important, but the spirit is. So we'll see this. The next article here, the drum beaters of dystopia. This article completely deals with blackout in Kashmir. The author says the Western media is having more influence than Indian media. They are getting more information than Indian media in terms of Kashmir. It says in Kashmir, Indian media are not allowed and Western media with their standalone presence in the areas are able to quark some information. Also gives an example which is not very relevant. He says even Nehru and Rajiv Gandhi have seen BBC than our news channels for authentic information. Developed countries' media are criticizing that India is not allowing the media personnel into Jammu and Kashmir. But let us take an example just to understand the situation. There is an area called Area 51 in United States. This is cordoned off by the United States defense. In this, even if you enter anywhere in this area or even you go through the airspace, the US administration shoots that flight or ship or anything which comes in between this area. We are not such autocratic or so strict in our things. We are only asking that Jammu and Kashmir is in a volatile situation and it takes time to stabilize, so give us time. We should also remember that India is a sovereign country. We have every right when to open our channels and when to close, and our human rights are not violated as portrayed by the different media sections of different parts of the world. And in India also there is some section of media which is highlighting that the media is being blocked out. Understand that in the past 70 years there is a decision being not taken, and when the decision is being taken it takes time to settle down, and it could be a very good investment opportunity for other players to come in. And when you create such volatile situation, the damage you are creating is more intense. So need not be influenced by the Western media, and our media personnel can have restraint and give time for Jammu and Kashmir to stabilize. We all know that media is the fourth pillar of democracy. There are a lot of things which media can highlight. There are many poor starvation deaths which can be highlighted by the media. Many unhealthy people are not getting treatment because of lack of awareness. NGOs are double fold. Some are working for the development and some are radicalizing. So media can highlight this both stands. There are so many things media can do rather than getting into the Jammu and Kashmir and asking for media communication to establish. Yes, when the government feels the situation of the country is mingled with Kashmir, government will surely uphold the values of Kashmiris and both Indians. So that is all about the article, the media being influenced by Western media. We have to be careful by not violating our constitution and our tranquility. This is all about the article. Next article here, the larger picture about inclusive programming. This is a small but important article. It deals about captioning for the deaf and hearing impairing people. That is to say that recently the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting has mandated captioning for TV programming. What does this mean? Captioning is nothing but, as we know, deaf and hearing impaired people cannot listen to the TV programs. Captioning should be happening in the bottom of the screen so that people can understand the essence of the video. Ministry of Information Broadcasting has now provided with a law that captioning should be done in phase-wise manner. By 2025, it should be accessible to all deaf people. This is the essence of article. There are minor details not necessary for the exam. The next article, facing up to reality. We know Chandrayaan 2 had, in the last minute, when it was in 2.1 kilometers, it has crashed, or you could say it has not been soft landed. What are this? We will make a separate article regarding this Chandrayaan 2 mission, its success, its failure, and what are the objectives. There are some four important points what the ISRO has mentioned in its website. What is the use of Chandrayaan 2 and why is it so special? We will see that four things. First is, this would be the first space mission to conduct a soft landing on the moon. Second one is, it is the first Indian expedition to attempt a landing on lunar surface using homegrown technology. We are not dependent on anybody when we are conducting this mission, and all is indigenous is the essence of the point. Next one is, the first Indian mission to explore the lunar terrain. Terrain is a surface. Fourth one, soft landing will be, if it is successful, it is the fourth country in the world which has done it. So this makes Chandrayaan 2 special. We'll, as I told you, we'll discuss Chandrayaan 2 in detail in a separate article. This is not an important article, and this is also not an important article. See the first article here, factoring in safety. That is, we know that factories are known as engines of growth because factories play a major important role to convert input to output. That is, raw material becomes the finished product. So factory plays a very important role in establishing a product. In the same way, it is our responsibility to ensure the health, safety and occupational readiness of the persons who are working in the factories. Article is critical about the industrial and occupational safety, and it is true that there is lacuna in the factories which have a consequence of number of fatalities and injuries. That is, death and injuries impact is high. Recently we have seen that ONGC had lost a sincere and senior officer with other fatalities in Navi Mumbai, and a firecracker factory in Bathinda, Punjab, almost a dozen people have been killed because of the occupational unreadiness and important precautions not being followed by the factories. To address the situation, the central government has come out with a bill called OSHWCC Code Bill 2019, that is Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions Code 2019, which was introduced in Lok Sabha recently. If we see the history of factories, before independence, when the British was ruling India and other parts of the world, the unhygienic conditions were prevailing and subjects, that is Indian people and other counterparts, were subjected to long hours of working, and there was no separate for men, women, children. Even children had to work for long hours without any leave. The situation was very deplorable. They were not given permanent employment. They were all temporary in nature. They could be taken out at any point of time. The miners and other employees did not have place or time to eat, did not have toilets and minimum basic infrastructure which is required for employment. So, understanding and taking cue from all these things, Indian government after independence has implemented a lot of laws. First and foremost and most important one is Factories Act 1948. Through this and other bills, number of provisions were added to make the people hygienic and work in a congenial environment. So, they have put a particular time, 8 hours and 6 days per week, etc., so that the efficiency of the both factories and the employees increase. Later on, factories and employees have formed a union called labor unions to fight for their rights and to highlight their problems to the government. From time to time, the labor unions used to raise the problems and the government used to solve them. But still, their occupational hazard was not taken very seriously. So still the hazards like the ONGC, Bhopal gas tragedy, if you look into the history, etc., have happened. So to address these problems and to empower the employees who are working, a new bill has been introduced in the Lok Sabha. It is called Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions Code Bill 2019. See the provisions of this bill, which is very important for the exam. In the mains, this could directly come as a question. It can be asked in General Studies Paper 2 and also General Studies Paper 3. So important article we will look into. The first it says is the code applies to establishments employing at least 10 workers and to all mines and docks. It does not apply to apprentices. That is to say, docks, you know, dockyards which are in near shipyards, and all mines, this code will be applied, and minimum condition is 10 workers should be there. Apprentices, you know, is they are employees but not permanent. They work for experience. They are called apprentices. So this law does not apply to apprentices. This bill makes special provisions for certain types of establishments and classes of employees, such as factories, mines, buildings and construction workers. That is, this bill segregates each of them so that their problems can be separately issued. Like factory problems are different, mines problems are different, buildings problems are different and construction worker problems are different. So for each of them, there is a special provision of establishment and classes of the employees. And this code repeals and replaces 13 labor laws relating to safety, health and working conditions. This include Factories Act 1948, Mines Act 1952, Contract Labor Regulation and Abolition Act 1970, etc. First, why do we have to replace and repeal 13 labor laws? Because there are a lot of cumbersome laws wherein the provision to protect the employee or any other provisions are not clearly mentioned in any of the acts. If you make them in 4 or 5 separate acts, it will be easy for difference. You don't have to refer into all 13 labor laws, which is cumbersome in nature. So filling and replacing is necessary. Provision is the relevant authorities. See, the all establishments covered by the code, that could include factories, mines, etc., should be registered with registering officers. Makes sense? Because see, when you are establishing a factory, it should be registered with the concerned authority, so that there would not be multiplicity. First point. Second is, you will know the occupational problems in that. And third and most important is uniformity. There would be a separate law for mining establishment. So when the registration happens, these mining authorities should have to follow, so that there will be uniformity in licensing, etc. Further, inspector cum facilitators may inquire into accidents and conduct inspections of establishments. Let us take an example. For example, a factory is running and it deals with noxious gases, they are poisonous gases. So if there are no regular audit by the inspectors, their chances of blowing off and accidents will increase. Regular inspections needs to be done. This bill empowers inspectors cum facilitators can inquire into the accidents and conduct inspections of establishments. Let us understand with an example. International, you know, IAEA, International Atomic Energy Agency. This is the agency which looks into atomic energy all over the world. For example, in India, some atomic plants are there. This body comes in with their inspectors to look into whether this can be converted to a bomb, whether it is pure, or is there any malfunction in it, or is India following the particular norms which are laid by IAEA. So inspection is a very important part in the factories. So this was an international example to understand the concept of inspection. Authorities are appointed by central or the state government. Additionally, the government may require certain establishments to set up safety committees comprising representatives of employers and workers. Next, bill highlights about advisory bodies. The central and state governments will set up occupational safety and health advisory boards at national and state level respectively. Self-explainable. These boards will advise the central and state governments on the standards, rules and regulations to be framed under the code. The bill also highlights the duties of the employers. The code specifies several duties of employers. This include providing a workplace that is free from hazards that may cause injury or disease. To say, the employer who is hiring the employees have to follow a work ethic, that is, he has to take care of his employees if there is any injury or disease. There are some occupational diseases. For example, if a person is working in a silicon industry, he may be infected with silicosis. He will have breathing problems. So in that way, the employer should take care whether these occupational hazards are not occurring and enough precautions are taken not to deteriorate his health. Next one is providing free annual health examinations to employees as prescribed. It is explainable because annual health checkup is required for them as they are hazardous in nature. If you are working with cement factory, you know that a lot of dust accumulates in the lungs and respiratory organs. So apart from giving their gadgets to protect them from this respiratory and lung diseases, It is also necessary to conduct a free annual health checkup to see the situation of the employee. In the last resort, in case of an accident at the workplace that leads to death or serious bodily injury of an employee, the employer must inform the relevant authorities about this incident and take the course of action. Rights and duties of the employees who are working in the organization. Duties of employees under the code include taking care of their own health and safety, complying with the specified safety and health standards. That is, for example, a mask should be worn when doing some particular work. If the mask is not being worn by the person, he may have health issues later on. So, he should comply with the specified safety and health standards and take care of his own health and safety. For example, if there is a leakage in a factory, the employee should highlight it to the employer or the inspector regarding this incident. That is to say, reporting unsafe situations to the inspector, every employee will have the right to obtain the employer information related to safety and health standards. That is to say, it is employee's right to understand the impact of the factory and its products being manufactured and how and what is the safety concerns being followed. This is the right of the employee, and employer cannot deny by saying that these are unnecessary things to you. So employee can ask for information related to his health and safety standards and also of his union. Discusses about the working hours for different classes of establishments and employees will be provided as per the rules prescribed by the central or state governments. For overtime work, the worker must be paid twice the rate of daily wages. Female workers, if at all they want to work, may work past 7 p.m. and before 6 a.m. if they are approved by the central and state governments. Earlier there was a clause that female employees were not eligible to work overtime and in the night hours, but now it has been relaxed. Code also talks about leave. No employee may work for more than 6 days a week. That is 1 day holiday minimum for a week. However, exceptions may be provided for motor transport workers, and workers must receive paid annual leave for at least 1 in 20 days for the period spent on duty. This is one of the clause added. For sales promotion employees who promote the sales, medical leave must be provided for at least 1/18 of the period of service. This much should be provided to the employee. During medical leave, the worker must be paid half his daily wages. Working conditions and the welfare facilities. The employer is required to provide a hygienic work environment with ventilation, that is, air should flow in into the factory and go out, comfortable temperature and humidity, sufficient space, clean drinking water and latrine, and urinal accommodations should be provided in the factory itself. Welfare facilities may be provided as per standards prescribed by the central government. These facilities may include separate bathing places, locker rooms for male, female and transgender employees, canteens, first aid boxes and crutches. We understand the importance of crutches. The maternity bill also, they say that if there are more than 50 employees, it is necessary to build a crutch wherein mother can feed the infant. In this way, care facilities should be provided to the employee by the employers. The offenses and penalties under the code, an offense that leads to the death of an employee will be punishable with imprisonment of up to 2 years or a fine up to 5 lakh rupees or both, depending on the situation. Further, courts may direct that at least 50% of such fine be given as compensation to the heirs of the victim. If a person has died due to some occupational hazard, 50% of the fine which have been collected should be given to their heirs, that is, their offsprings. or any other violation where the penalty is not specified, the employer will be penalized with a fine between 2 and 3 lakh rupees. For example, if an employer violates provisions of the code, he will be subjected to a fine of up to 10,000. That is, both employer and employee are under the bill. We have seen a rosy picture of the bill, but there are some issues also which are being highlighted by the author. First is formation of safety committees and appointment of safety officers. If we observe, there is a huge recruitment gap in the safety officers. They are not being employed as per the required norms. And Factory Act mandates appointment of bipartite committee in units that employ hazardous substances. Act 1948 mandates that bipartite committee, that is two committees, should employ for hazardous substances. So what should be done? We have discussed about factories, their history, what are the occupational hazards, what is the bill, what are the issues being there. So what is required now to solve the problem? First is, the employees should be empowered. That is, they should be knowing of their rights. Second, the equipments should be modernized according to the necessity. Requisite protective shields be provided by the factories to avoid exposure of different chemical substances or physical damage. So what could be done? Safe working right is a basic right of an employee, and he should be given guarantee framework regarding that. That is, if you are joining an factory, they should guarantee your security and health. If you see ILO, International Labour Organization, which covers organized and unorganized sector workers, it also says that Occupational Safety and Health Convention 1981 should be followed. This convention has given a lot of precautionary measures which are now included in this bill, and this bill will be a progressive one. It also says safety needs to be taken care of and extreme consequences should be ensured. When our country wants to become the superpower in the world in the coming decades, it is our necessity to develop on our manufacturing sector. We are already putting steps by Make in India, Make with India, Make for India, etc. But this should be added with the labor safety. Both manufacturing plus labor safety should go hand in hand so that both can take the fruits of development. The next article is, Nadal has won his 19th Grand Slam, Federer is it at his 20th, and Djokovic is his 16th. The spirit of the article is, if we observe, tenacity of the players has increased. They being above 30 plus are still working hard, and these three, you can call them Trimurti of tennis, because they have almost monopolized the tennis. Just know the fact, 51 out of 59 matches which have been played are won by three of them. That is, 51 matches are won by either of the three. So they have almost monopolized even at the age of 30, 32 and 33 age. Understand the spirit of these people, the passion which they are continuing for more than a decade. They are all having injuries, they are all having their problems, they are all having fitness issues, still they are playing significantly and winning all the matches. You have to learn from them the tenacity, the work ethic and the perseverance. Many people have told them to retire themselves from the matches as they were not winning at some point of time, but still they are again coming back, reverting back and again shooting. So this spirit is required for every aspirant like us. On the other hand, if we see in the women's championship, Serena Williams, who is the highest scorer till now, is being defeated by the youngest player, who is of 19 years. So there is always a scope for new and old, or experienced, you could say. And the best of the best are coming in. So practice, practice and practice is the mantra which we can take it from the players. On this note, thank you very much.